a pair of linear equations in two variable. We have studied linear equations in two variable. Now we have to study pair of linear equations in two variable. When we use more than one, means two linear equations simultaneously, then we say these are simultaneous linear equations in two variables. And this simultaneous linear equations in two variable also known as pair of linear equations in two variables. As 2x plus 3y is equal to 4, 4x minus 2y is equal to 3. This one is a linear equation in two variable. This one is also a linear equation in two variable. When we use both of them simultaneously and find out a common solution of x and y for both of them, then we say it is a pair of linear equation or simultaneous linear equations in two variables. So first, how to find out the solutions of these linear equations in two variables? The first method to find out the solution of this is a graphical method. As we know, to plot the graphs of the linear equation on the coordinate system, but how we find out the solution of two linear equations in two variables by the graphical method? So here it is. Graphical method to find out the solution of linear equations in two variables. In the graphical method, we have to first plot the graph of both of the linear equations. After plotting the graph, we have to see that these lines are intersecting or not. What are these lines doing? Means they are intersecting, they are coinciding, or they are parallel. Three conditions may be there. If these lines are intersecting, if lines intersect, it means A1 upon A2 is not equals to B1 upon B2, where A1, B1, A2, B2 are the coefficients in that equation. As let's say there is an equation A1x plus B1y is equals to C1, and the second one is A2x plus B2y is equals to C2. If these are the two linear equations, here is a pair. So for this equation, A1 upon A2 is not equal to B1 upon B2, then we can say that lines are intersecting. Or if we plot the graph, when we get the intersecting lines, we can say this. So the conclusion of this condition is, this conclusion says that here a unique solution exists. Here a unique solution for that system exists. In the second case, it may be that lines are coincident. If lines are coincident, there will be a condition like this: A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 upon B2 is equals to C1 upon C2. In this condition, A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2 and C1 upon C2 all are the equal, means lines are coincident. If it means lines are one upon each other, then there will be infinite solutions. And the third and the last case is lines are parallel. When lines are parallel, the condition will be A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 upon B2 but not equals to C1 upon C2. In this case, no solution exists. So here are the three conditions. After plotting the graph, we will have lines intersect each other. Then we can say that unique solution exists. If lines are coincident with each other, then there will be infinite solutions. If lines are parallel to each other, means if lines will be not intersecting each other, they are parallel to each other, it is obviously that there will be no solution for these lines. So how we do, let's have an example. A pair of linear equations is given as x plus y is equals to 3 and 3x minus 2y is equals to 4. We have to plot the graph of these two lines, then we will find out the solution for this pair. So how we do that? For x plus y is equals to 3, if we have to plot the graph of this line, then x and y, at x is equals to 0, y will be 3, and x at y is equals to 0, x will be 3. This is the first one for this line. Now for the second, if we put x is equals to 0 here, we will have y is equals to minus 2. At x is equals to 0, y is equals to minus 2. At y is equals to 0, there will be a fractional answer. So leave y is equals to 0 dot bracket. Now if we have y is equals to 1, so there will be 2 minus 2. If we shift minus 2 there, 4 plus 2 will be there, and we will have a non-fractional answer. As if y is equals to 1, then we will have 3x minus 2 into 1 is equals to 4. So 3x is equals to 4 plus 2, 6. This implies x is equals to 2. So if we take y is equals to minus 1, then we will say x will be 2. Now we have the values of the coordinates, so we can plot the graph. So now we have this graph, we have to plot first of this line. So x is equals to 0, y is equals to 3. So let's 1, 2, 3, 4, enough. Now minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, here also minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4, and then here 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now plot the graph. At x is equals to 0, y is equals to 3. At x is equals to 0, y is equals to 3. So this is the point. At y is equals to 0, x is equals to 3. At y is equals to 0, x is equals to 3. here. Join these two points. So now we have the graph of first equation, x plus y is equals to 3. Now for the second one, at x is equals to 0, y is equals to minus 2. At x is equals to 0, y is equals to minus 2. And at x is equals to 2, y is minus 1. At x is equals to 2, y is minus 1. Means this is the point. This one, and now we have two of these points. So join them. Let's check our graph system. First, at x plus y is equals to 3, at x is equals to 0, y is equals to 3, right? At y is equals to 0, x is equals to 3, again right? Then, at x is equals to 0, if x is equals to 0, then it is minus 2y is equals to 4, then y is equals to 4 upon minus 2, that is minus 2, it is correct. Then, if we put y is equals to minus 1, then there will be plus 2, and here, here is a mistake. So this graph is incorrect. Now what the system to check it out that your graph is correct or not, your solution is correct or not. For that, if we know to solve these algebraically, we are going to study this next. So if we have to solve this algebraically, then we will solve them and check the solutions by graph and by the algebraic method. If they are similar, then this method is correct, or we can say our graph is correct. But here algebraically this method is giving some other answer, and after plotting the graph, this graph was giving another answer. It means my graph was incorrect. So to do correct this graph, if I put minus 1 here, again it is 4 minus 2, so it will be 2 divided by 3. It is a fractional number, so what we will have to do, that we have a non-fractional number. So let's put 4 here. If we will put 4 here, so it is 4 to the 8, 4 minus 8. And when minus 8 will go there, 8 plus 4 will be 12, and then we will have x is equals to 4. Now it is correct. That time when we put minus 1, there was a mistake that when minus 1 we will put, it will go there, and if this is minus 1 into minus 2, plus will be there. So it, when we will shift it, there will be 4 minus 2 again. So it is 2. So there will be a fractional number. So always concentrate on these things. Do not go directly when you put here, just solve them apart and check your answers that they are correct or not. So now at 4, x is equals to 4, this is a correct answer. Now plot this graph. X is equals to 0, it is minus 2, and x is equals to 4, y is equals to 4. At x is equals to 4, y is equals to 4. Here will be the point. So at the intersection point of these two lines, you will have a answer of this. This intersection point is somewhat goes to 2 and here for 1, makes at the y axis the answer is 1 and for the x axis the answer is 2. So we will say this solution will be x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 1. So this is the solution of this pair of linear equation. So this is the method to solve linear equations in a pair by a graphical method. Just draw the graph as we know how to draw the graphs. Just see where they intersect, draw the perpendicular lines for the both of the axes, then where they meet, this will be the point of your intersection, means x is equals to 2, y is equals to 1, this is your answer. Now the next one, what we have to do, again there is a system of linear equations, we have to plot the graph of the linear equations, we have to solve them, we have to get the solution of the linear equation, then after that we have to find the area enclosed by these two lines as well as x axis. The question is, equations are 2x plus y is equals to 6 and 2x minus y is equals to minus 2. So these are our equations, 2x plus y is equals to 6, 2x minus y is equals to minus 2. Now for that we have to get the solution of these systems, and then after that we have to get the area enclosed by the two lines and as well as with the x axis. So leave the second thing apart, first find out the solution for these equations. To do that, plot the graph, 2x plus y is equals to 6, for 2x plus y is equals to 6, x and y. At x is equals to 0, y will be 6. At y is equals to 0, x will be 3. Always the feasible solution is to put the zeros for both of the coordinates. Maybe it gives you the non-fractional answer. If it gives you the non-fractional answer, it is a very feasible solution. If it is, it does not give, then go ahead. Then for 2x minus y is equals to minus 2. For these equations, when x is equals to 0, y is equals to 2, and when y is equals to 0, x is equals to minus 1. For x is equals to 0, y is equals to 2, and for y is equals to 0, x will be minus 1. Now plot the graph of this. This is the origin. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, You have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now plot the graph for the first x is equal to 0, y is equal to 6. At x is equal to 0, y is equal to 6. So we need one more point. So x is equal to 0, y is equal to 6, this is the desired coordinate. Now at y is equal to 0, x is equal to 3. At y is equal to 0, x is equal to 3, this is the next desired coordinate. Now join these two points. For the next time, at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. At x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. And at y is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1. At y is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1. Join them. So now these two lines intersect here. At the intersection point of these two lines are because of the graphical dimensions it will be 3. This intersection point will be at 3 because of no graphical measurements are here, so it will be some distracted. So it is this point will be 3 and 2 for y. Sorry, this point will be 1 for x axis and this 4 for y axis. Not so much distraction is there, just it is 1 and 4. So this is the intersection point. It means we can say that x is equals to 1 and y is equals to 4 is solution for these two linear equations. Means for this pair of linear equations, this is the solution where x will be 1 and y is equals to 4. Now what the question says again, that find out the area enclosed by these two lines and x axis. This red one. Area enclosed by these two lines and x axis. Means this area we have to find. As we see that this is a triangle. This is a triangle. For area of a triangle, we know 1 by 2 base into height is a formula. So area of, name it as this point is A, this is B, and this point is C. So area of triangle ABC is 1 by 2 base into height. So it is 1 by 2. What the base of this triangle? Base of this triangle is this. So what's the length of this base? As we see, from the origin, in the direction of x, there are 3 units. So 1, 2, 3. 3 units here and 1 unit in this negative direction, minus 1, 2, minus 1. So it is 1 unit and 3 units there are. So total will be 4 units of base. 1 unit from negative direction to origin and 3 units from origin to positive direction. So there will be 4 units for the base. Then height. Height means the coordinate of y. So it is 4 again As we see, this is the height of this chord triangle which goes to the coordinate 4. Y coordinate 4. So that is why it is 4 height, base is equal to 4 and 1 by 2. So this is 8 units will be the area of this triangle. As we don't know what is the unit of them, centimeter or meter is not given as, so we will see units will be there at the place of area's unit. So this is the system to solve graphically the linear equations in two variables.